So we actually had an interview with you with our Jason Burgos a couple months ago. I think he was talking to you about how you pushed a fight aside to get married. Mm-hmm. So I guess the first question, how's marriage
doing? It's great. Yeah, it's amazing. I'm very happy with my decision to get married and not cancel my wedding on 5 weeks for the title fight, because a couple months later I'm in the same position. Yeah.
So the next question, actually this is a follow-up from Mr. Burgos. So what would you say is more stressful, planning a wedding or preparing for a UFC title fight?
Preparing for a title fight, definitely. I think that most girls that have weddings have never fought, and they don't understand what's important and what's pressure. You know, they've never done a weight cut. Some of my friends are getting married and they're like, it's so stressful. I'm like, when I had my wedding, they're like, are you stressed? I'm like, wait, the whole week before, they're like, that's the most stressful week. I'm like, you've never had fights. I'm like, I get to like eat and drink and hang out with my friends and my family for a week. I'm like, do fight week and then tell me if this wedding is stressful.
Sounds perfect. That sounds way easier.
Yeah, yeah.
So I guess we're going to talk about the fight. So I think you're the underdog for the first time in a long time. Mm-hmm. Is there anything you feel going into that? It's just another day. I mean, it's a title fight, but, you know, being the underdog and fighting the champion who's 4-0 in the division.
Yeah.
So that's not, you know, the biggest number. What does it feel like being the underdog again?
Yeah, I mean, my whole career, if I have been an underdog, it was very slight.
Yes.
You know, this is my first, I would say I technically was, but this is my first, like, real fight being the underdog. But, yeah, I mean, it just feels the same. I mean, I've had fights where I was a little bit more of a favorite, and it was a really tough, close fight. So it doesn't really matter to me. If anything, it's less pressure on me.
Yeah, I think the last time was when you fought Lauren Murphy, actually. Mm-hmm. I think it was the last time you were the underdog, so it's been a while.
Yeah.
But, you know, you won that fight, took it home. So, to the bettors, the people that are looking at this fight and seeing that you're a good underdog, what is it that you can bring to the table to prove them, this is why you should bet on me, this is why I'm going to take it home?
Well, you know, I mean, I think at this point, the betting odds are out, and they kind of have their mind already. I think when I go in and win, I think the odds will change on the next fight with her.
I like it.
Yeah.
So, we're going to switch gears a little bit. So, walkout music. You got to talk.
Okay.
So, DMX, where did that come from, and what does that walkout song mean to you?
Okay. Yeah. So when I was a kid and I used to do karate tournaments, I had a brother who was 4 years older than me, and I always, that's why I started karate, because he did it, and I just always wanted to like be like him and do whatever he did, so he would like, you know, hang out with me and let me play with him. And before karate tournaments, and this is when he was in like, you know, ninth grade, he thought he was really cool, and he'd like on his Walkman would listen to DMX, and he's like, this pumps me up before a tournament. So then I started listening to it, and I was like, yeah, okay, this makes me tough, and this is like before I would do like small local karate tournaments, I would listen to DMX on my Walkman, and I was like just trying to act tough because I would see my brother doing it. And then throughout my career, I just always had random songs as my walkout song. Nothing really like stuck with me. It was just like, I don't really care, nothing pumps me up. And then one time someone's like, you should use a DMX song, like, because you're so used to it. And I was like, yeah, you're right. And then it's just kind of like brings me back to those days. That was the only time in my life where like a song pumped me up, so I just kind of stuck with that.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, I think it's been a couple fights now that it just the change was yeah, 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 or something like that.
Yeah.
But then this is the one you go, okay, you feel, different when that song comes on the arena. You feel that kind of internally?
Yeah, it just kind of puts you back into that place where, like, when I was younger and I used to be like, okay, I feel tough listening to this and I feel like a badass. So it just kind of puts you back in that mindset.
So the last question I have for you is about being a badass. So we're going to go back a couple years to a film you were actually part of, Fight Valley.
Yeah.
So looking back on that a couple years later, you know, how do you feel about being in that film? Because you were, I think you fought the main character or something like that.
Yeah. Me and Misha Tate had like a fight scene together, which was kind of funny because I was like, before I was even in the UFC, and they were like, hi, how are you? I'm like, I'm Katlyn. And like, it was only like a one day thing. It was fun, but like, you know, meanwhile, like in my head at that time, I was like with Misha, she was still fighting, and I was like, you know, I'm like on the cusp of making it in the UFC. I'm kind of like, hi, how are you? But I was also like sizing her up, and Holly was there, and I was like, all right, I'm moving to 135. Hope we get these girls. Like, and I was kind of sizing them up, but it was great. It was fun. They were all really nice.
So I guess a follow up. They're making another one. I just found out today they're making a sequel. It's called Lockdown.
Okay.
Do you have any plans on
Well, I haven't heard anything about it, but maybe if they ask, it was nice. Last time they were filming in Jersey, so it was super convenient. Right. So yeah, he would do it. It was, I don't know how great the movie was as far as Greg's, but it was a fun experience, and it was just fun to do with a bunch of other girls, like girl fighters. It was just fun.
Well, that's it for me. Jay Petra from Sherdog, Katlyn Chookagian, flyweight contender, fighting for the belt. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.